Jeter, Mr. Hirohito, Harry Truman, Benito Mussolini, and Adolf Hitler. We're going to be talking about them. And then last but not least, go ahead, Jakari.
I
commentary on product. Truman, all right. Anybody else? All right, well, great.
This point intervention is called for the attendance.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
Uh-huh. So, by the end of the period, you should be able to identify these key people, and you should be able to explain to me these key things that allowed the United States to enter into World War II. All right, let's go ahead. Let's turn our books. Let's turn our social studies books. Page 174. Let's go ahead and turn it to 170. In my hand. Page 174. All right, well, I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to jump off the first paragraph, and then I'm going to get my other readers. All right, so pick it back up. Yeah, we already looked at that. All right, page 174. It says, it was said that the German people were part of a master race called Aryan. He claimed that Germany had the right to expand its territory with the alliance with Italy and Japan in place. Hitler began to expand German power throughout Europe. All right, let's go ahead and speak up with our next reader. All right, great. Go ahead, Ms. Cruz. In 1938. Go ahead, either one. Austria. The Treaty of Versailles. Germany conquered Czechoslovakia. It's okay. It's okay. It's Czechoslovakia. Keep going. In 1939, alliance, Soviet, socialist. All right, the USSR. Operated communism. Great job, Mr. Cruz. Alright, go ahead. Alright, great. Go ahead, Tamir. And I see you, Ms. Swain, and my other readers. I see you, Price, and I got you on the last paragraph. Alright, so we're going to stop right there. We're going to stop right there. Now, here we go. Going back to IG. What was going on in Europe that may have caused the United States to join in World War II? Who was really the power player in Europe at this time? Go ahead, Smith. Adolf Hitler was part of what country? Germany. And what did Germany want to do with most of Europe? Take it over and conquer it. Now, who's a friend of the United States? And what country is a friend of the United States? Yeah. Joseph Stalin is a person. What country? What other countries have you seen it? France and Britain. So when France and Britain were attacked, the United States came into the war. All right. everybody will get an opportunity to rotate to the stations between today and tomorrow. So if you don't get to get to one of the prime stations at this moment, you will get to in the next few minutes. All right, so this is what I need us to do. Josh, go ahead, log on to the computer. Jamie, go ahead, log on to the computer. Janaya, go ahead, log on to the computer. Josh Blazers, go ahead, log on to the computer. Your technology assignment is at the computer. All right, my group right here. Y'all going to be working on that. Okay, I get you in the next assignment. All right, so my people right here, we're going to be working on our math skills. Our directions tell us, it says use the math from my social studies book on page 134. You're going to label the following countries. You're going to close your axis, how it was red, and the allied power was blue. Thank you for those people to be able to identify Mr. France, who was an ally of the United States, not Germany, that was Axis, and Great Britain. Serbia. No, those are going to be Axis powers. Axis powers. All right. Now, and France. Thank you, France. All right, last bit. Josh, can you tell us what did Hitler promise? He promised to make Germany strong again. Now, Josh, on the next thing, what did Mr. Hitler do to the Jews? Religion? Alright, he had a different religion than the people of Germany. And that's why Hitler ended up mistreating them. Are you going to add something to wrap us up? Any and all work that you have, go ahead and put it in the pile. I'm going to send somebody around.